subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures, and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Yeshi, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to the Kanyakumari. There's an old saying that teacher is like a candle that consumes itself to light the way for others. Amid this time of pandemic, this saying has become much more prominent as teachers across the country are coming up with a number of innovative methods to educate their students. Recently, as the country celebrated the Teachers' Day, let's see how these heroes are going above and beyond the call of duty to impart lessons to their students. From conducting community classes to using augmented reality, teachers have gone an extra mile amid the pandemic to impart lessons to students. In Jammu and Kashmir, teachers have been holding open-air community classes in various districts to help students make up for the academic loss during the lockdown. Despite the pandemic, they have been regularly taking classes while following the social distancing norms. Similar scenes can also be witnessed in Madurai city of Chennai, where teachers have taken upon themselves to keep the children from impoverished communities who have no access to technology stay connected with education. With masks on and textbooks in their hands, children sit on a cemented platform in the school premises where their teachers give them lessons.
அதே நேரங்களில் பள்ளிக்கும் மாணவர்களுக்கும் உள்ள தொடர்பு வந்து குறையுது. இந்த காலகட்டத்தில் நிறைய குடும்பங்கள் வந்து ஏழ்மை நிலையில் இருக்காங்க. அந்த குழந்தைகளையும் கூட்டிகிட்டு போகிற வேலைக்கு கூட்டி போகிற ஒரு சூழ்நிலையும் ஏற்பட்டுருக்கு. ஸோ இந்த விஷயங்கள்லாம் என்னென்னா அடுத்து ட்ராப் அவுட் இடைநிலை ட்ராப் அவுட் இல்லாமல் பள்ளிக்கூடம் வர்றதுக்கு நாங்கள் ஒரு ஆயத்தமாக இந்த வேலையை செஞ்சுக்கிட்டு இருக்கோம்.
At few places, the determination of teachers has just gone to the next level. At a village in Maharashtra, a teacher can be seen imparting lessons to his students using smartphones while sitting atop a tree to get a better network connectivity. The tireless efforts of teachers can also be seen in Moradabad district of Uttar Pradesh, where they are imparting knowledge about online classes to students in rural areas amid the pandemic. Teachers are personally visiting the students and teaching them the usage of Diksha online app that offers teachers, students and parents to engage in learning material which is relevant to the prescribed school curriculum.
लॉकडाउन के दौरान कुछ बच्चों की शिकायत आई थी कि वो दीक्षा ऐप का सही तरीके से उपयोग नहीं कर पा रहे हैं. इसके लिए मैंने अध्यापकों से अनुरोध किया कि जब वो गांव में डिटेल लेने जा रहे हैं तो उनकी समस्याओं को भी दूर करें और दीक्षा ऐप को बहुत अच्छे ढंग से कैसे यूज किया जाए उसको भी बताएं।
एक दिन आया लंबा राजा।
Even at online classes, teachers are putting a lot of efforts to make studies interesting for the students.
I want to go to visit zoo. I want to visit the zoo, Daddy.
Using augmented reality, they are reinventing the experience of learning in this online teaching era.
Yes, lion roars. Can you see the lion?
At a school in Vadodara city of Gujarat, teachers are using various types of technologies to entertain kids and give them education in a fun and playful method.
In catchy section, children are very, very small. तो उनको थोड़ा interesting बताना है, हमें कुछ typical method से नहीं जाना है. For example, हमारा concept था animals and birds. तो उनको कैसे interesting तरीके से दिखा है कि उनका interest create हो, तो वो खुश हो. That's why we have bring this augmented reality. Augmented reality से बच्चों को लगता है कि हम लोग classroom में real animals लेके आए हैं, birds लेके आए
हैं.
The contribution of teachers to the society can never be expressed in words, and the dedication they have shown in performing their duties even amid the pandemic makes them no less than a warrior. It's been said that kindness costs nothing but means everything. Several examples of kindness can be witnessed in nooks and corners of the country, strengthening the common bond shared by citizens of different castes and cultures who are collectively residing in India. One such act of selfless service was recently seen in Mayurbhanj district of Odisha, where youngsters of different religions united for feeding the mentally challenged poor in the district amid the weekend shutdown. Have a look.
Sometimes a single act of kindness is enough to move, inspire or change lives of individuals. In times of the great pandemic, a number of individuals, organizations and groups have stepped up to help the needy and provide them with assistance that is helpful in sustaining their lives. A similar act of kindness was recently witnessed in the eastern state of Orissa, where a group of youngsters decided to make special efforts and feed the mentally challenged people regardless of their religious backgrounds.
Hum sab without any discrimination, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, hum sab bhai milke hum apne aap se jo bhi mentally retired person hai aur jo bhi log matlab is shutdown ki wajah se matlab vanchit ho rahe hain khane se, hum un logo ko hamari taraf se
Based in Mayurbhanj district, the Jesus Christ Shutdown Unit is a group of 15 to 20 youngsters who decided to join hands and provide food to the mentally retarded poor in the district. These youngsters save money from their pockets, which is utilized for preparing home-cooked meal for the poor and is distributed among them without any discrimination. The group was formed when authorities in Orissa announced a complete two-day weekend lockdown, which made it difficult for the mentally challenged poor in the district to survive.
जो अभी कोरोना वायरस के वजह से जो शटडाउन चल रहा है, तो हम लोग के पास जो भी 10 रुपए हम लोग इनकम करते हैं, 8 रुपए रख के 2 रुपए जिसका माथे नहीं काम कर रहा है, जिसको खाना नहीं मिल रहा, हम लोग शटडाउन में खाना देते हैं सबको। जितना दिन शटडाउन चल रहा है, तो आगे तक शटडाउन रहेगा, तो हम लोग जरूर देंगे। तो मेरा ये मैसेज देना चाहता हूँ सारे इंडिया को, आप लोग के पास भी, आप लोग के पास कुछ खाना है तो आप लोग भी जरूर आके खाना दीजिए।
This act of kindness by a group of mindful youngsters in Mayurbhanj is not just inspirational for the citizens, but also delivers the message of communal harmony among the people of different communities.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Women in a small village of Uttar Pradesh decided to become sole breadwinners for families after their husbands lost work because of coronavirus pandemic.
It is the monthly meeting of the women where they meet and analyze the numbers of the small business and record it in their passbooks. The women of Praladpur village have leased lands with the help of a self-help group and grow vegetables and flowers on the land. Vegetables and fruits being essential items, the women were allowed to sell their produce in market even during lockdown.
ये लोग पट्टे पे खेत लेते हैं और खेत को लेके अपना सब्जी उगाते हैं, फूल की खेती करते हैं और सब्जी मंडी में बेचते हैं, फूल को भी मंडी में बेचते हैं और उस समय थोड़ा सा दिक्कत आई, लेकिन इन लोगों ने समूह के माध्यम से अपना रोजी रोटी को चलाया.
A part of the most populous state and one of the worst affected in the country, this village is exemplary in dealing with the pandemic and its microeconomic effects on households.
Authorities have taken measures to curb the spread of the coronavirus at India-Nepal border by conducting regular checks and taking precautions. Body temperatures of passengers coming from Nepal were being checked at the Sanoli border area to detect any suspected coronavirus carriers. People were also being sanitized upon their arrival.
ये कोविड 19 का जब प्रकोप ज़्यादा बढ़ने लगा तो हम लोगों ने इंडियन अपने बॉर्डर पर सैनिटाइज का काम करना शुरू किया, टनल बनाया, जो भी नेपाल से इंडिया में आ रहे हैं उनको पहले यहाँ पर सैनिटाइज करके उनको कोविड की जांच भी करा रहे हैं, तब इंडिया में प्रवेश कर रहे हैं. और वैसे भी नेपाल से इंडियन आर्मी या जो हिंदुस्तान के लोग हैं नेपाल में किसी कारण से हैं वहाँ पर, चाहे जॉब कर रहे हों, वही अलाउ हैं, बाकी नेपाल के लोग अलाउ नहीं हैं.
This step has been taken by the authorities in the wake of rising coronavirus cases in India.
Members of the transgender community in Chennai have taken it upon themselves to take the COVID-19 fight to the next level in the slums of city. Transgender community members, armed with pamphlets, thermal scanners and recording books, head to the slum areas and raise awareness about social distancing, importance of mask and also record temperatures and pulses of the slum dwellers on behalf of Chennai Municipal Corporation.
எங்களை ஒரு இதுவாக பார்த்து அச்சமாக பார்த்து எங்களை நல்லா நாங்கள் ஒரு ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஷிப்பாக பழகி அவங்களுக்கு எந்த ஒரு பிரச்சனை அவங்க நாங்கள் கேட்க முடியும், அவங்களுக்கு சளி இருக்கா இருமல் இருக்கா எங்ககிட்ட பயப்படாமல் சொல்கிறாங்க. இப்போ வந்து சளி இருந்தால் ஹாஸ்பிட்டலுக்கு கூட்டு போயிறாங்க, ஜுரம் இருந்தால் ஹாஸ்பிட்டலுக்கு, அந்த மாதிரி அவங்க பயத்தை நீக்கி.
Amid the pandemic, there are a number of people who are coming forward and contributing their bit to the society.
India successfully tested a hypersonic vehicle and also accomplished a flight of up to 6 times the speed of sound. This test puts India into select club of nations who have demonstrated this technology. India has become the 4th country after the USA, Russia and China to demonstrate this technology.
The hypersonic test demonstration vehicle, which is successfully flight tested from interim test range off the coast of Bay of Bengal from Orissa, is a major technological breakthrough of the country. The scramjet engine has been successfully flight tested at hypersonic speeds within the atmosphere.
The test was conducted off the southeastern coast of India on Abdul Kalam Island, formerly known as Wheeler Island. The test is essentially the first step towards the development of an entire family of very high cruise missiles and other weapon systems.
As the Indian government is busy battling coronavirus outbreak, a number of citizens and organizations are also not behind in extending their support to the needy people who are worst affected by this pandemic, be it through in distributing essential items or providing ambulance services. They have been contributing their bit without making any discrimination on the basis of caste and community. Let's take a look at a similar example in Ludhiana city of Punjab.
COVID-19 has posed several challenges to the society. Deficit in number of dedicated COVID-19 ambulances is one among them. Many people across the country who have succumbed to deadly virus had to face a lot of problems due to their unavailability. In such a situation, a voluntary organization in Ludhiana city of Punjab has come to the rescue of COVID-19 patients, no matter which caste or community they belong to. Till date, Samvedna Trust has distributed around 100,000 masks, 50,000 sanitizers, 40,000 pair of gloves, 15,000 surgical caps and 4,000 protective suits across the city. Along with this, it is also helping coronavirus patients in reaching hospitals and performing the last rites of deceased patients.
हमने अपना प्रयास किया, हमने अब तक जो हमारे जिम्मे ईश्वरीय कार्य लगा उस कार्य में हमने लगभग 300 जो कोविड पेशेंट हैं पॉजिटिव उनको अस्पताल पहुंचाया और 269 जो डेड बॉडीज हैं उनके लास्ट राइट्स के लिए हमने क्रिमिनेशन करवाया.
The team has a dedicated ambulance and practices high hygiene standards while dealing with the bodies. They wear personal protective equipments and sanitize their vehicles and equipment every time. Though the task is risky, but the volunteers of Samvedna Trust remain undeterred in their efforts to serve the society and are therefore garnering praise from residents across the city.
ये बेचारे फिर भी ये भाग दौड़ करके हमारी बॉडी को यहाँ लेके आए हैं और इन्होंने हमें से पैसा भी कोई नहीं लिया. हम तो ये चाहते हैं कि इनको भी भगवान और शक्ति दे के एक आध गाड़ी और चला के ये जैसे घूमते हैं. हमने फोन किया तो ये तुरंत आ गए.
Rising above religious biases and working with only motive to serve the humanity, this is what this voluntary organization has been doing. Their work is inspiration for everyone to come forward and help the country at this time of need.
In recent times, when the pandemic has dropped citizens and organizations worldwide, a number of them decided to fight back and come up with different ideas to utilize this lockdown and become a better version of them. One such example was recently witnessed in Coimbatore city of Tamil Nadu, where people of the transgender community decided to open their own restaurant with the motive of becoming self-reliant and pave their way towards living a dignified life. Have a look.
In a first of its kind initiative, a restaurant has been opened by the transgender community in Coimbatore city of Tamil Nadu. Named as the Kovai Trans Kitchen, the restaurant has been opened by 10 transgenders whose livelihood was severely hit due to the pandemic, which further pushed them to start a venture of their own. Started with the motive of barely serving as a source of livelihood for its owners, the Trans Kitchen is now wooing citizens with a variety of dishes like biryani, along with making rounds on the social media.
I'm a social worker, so I thought of visiting here and I just came to appreciate them, what they are doing actually. And once I come here only, I just came to know that they are doing extraordinary things, like they are supporting and making employment for transgenders and supporting financially and with various facilities they are providing the transgenders as well as to the public also. Now they are serving with this hotel. So just with an idea to appreciate, we came.
Located in the Arasapuram area of Coimbatore city, the restaurant has been started with the support of government schemes and some non-profit and religious groups. Created by the Transgender Association of Coimbatore, the functioning of the kitchen, right from preparation of the food to its packaging and delivering, is entirely being carried out by the 10 trans members. The restaurant staff had undergone training at the CSI Bishop Appaswamy College of Arts and Science, because of which the restaurant members started making profits of around Rs 2,000 on a daily basis. Brainchild of Sangeeta, president of Coimbatore District Transgender Association, the restaurant is receiving praises from everywhere. In lieu of the success and positive response received, its owners are also planning to start a second branch of it.
கடந்த 10 வருஷமாக திருநங்கைகளுக்காக சங்க கோவை மட்டும் திருநங்கைகள் சங்கம் சொல்லி வச்சு மக்களுக்காக சேவை செய்து வருகிறேன். இப்போ திருநங்கைகள் நல ஒரு அக்கறையாக இப்போ சமீபத்தில் தமிழ்நாட்டிலே முதல் முறையாக டிரான்ஸ் கிச்சன், அதாவது திருநங்கைகள் கிச்சன் ஆரம்பிச்சிருக்கிறேன்னு. இதில் வந்து 10 திருநங்கைகளுக்கு வேலைவாய்ப்பு கொடுக்கும் விதத்தில் நோக்கத்தில் ஆரம்பிச்சிருக்கிறேன். இதுக்கு வந்து யூடபிள்யூசி, யுனைடெட் வே ஆஃப் சென்னை அண்டு சிஎஸ்ஐ அப்பாமி அப்பாசாமி காலேஜ் அண்டு ஸ்வஸ்தி இந்த நிறுவனங்கள் மூலமாக ஃபண்டு எங்களுக்கு கொடுத்து இது ஊக்குவித்து எங்கள் சங்கத்து மூலமாக கோவை மாவட்டத்தில் திருநங்கைகளுக்காக ஒரு கிச்சன் ஆரம்பிச்சிருக்கிறேன். இதனால் 10 திருநங்கைகள் வேலைவாய்ப்புக்கு வேலைவாய்ப்பு கிடைக்க போகுது. ஸோ இது இனி வருங்காலத்தில் 6 மாதத்தில் நல்ல வியாபாரமாகி ரன்னிங் ஆச்சுனாக்கா இன்னொரு யூனிட் ஆரம்பிக்கிறதுக்கு நான் வந்து முயற்சி எடுத்துட்ருக்கேன்.
Fighting against all odds, these trans women have turned out to be an inspiration not just for citizens in Coimbatore but across the nation.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Yeshi, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.